Hey, Kid Factory Dwellers. Well, this is the final update, the grand finale for the USS Sulaco Marine Transport. It's actually something denoted as on the plaque as a light carrier or light destroyer or something like that. It's done. It's finally done. But it only took just roughly over 3 weeks, just short of a month, I think. Being a 3D printed kit, it was very easy to put together, I agree, but the time I took to paint and detail was the same as any other time, so it's a terrific tool. You can get a kit rapidly done and all that, but it doesn't change the skill involved in detailing or making a kit authentic looking. That's something that no matter what, unless, you know, maybe in 10 years when machines get really slick and can think like we can, which they probably will and we're all doomed, then it's still our parameter. So we'll take a look at her on the table in the light and in the dark. Right now we're filming on a new camera known as the HXRC 2500 Sony. It is a brand new camera I got. It's supposedly very good in low lighting, as you know. The Canon is excellent at taking daytime shots. It's like as clear as you can possibly get, and it's known in the industry as the clearest optical quality lens there is. However, in low light, I've been not so satisfied, and that's with my last three Canon video cameras. They're just not good in low lighting, so this guy's supposed to be something else on that. So we'll give him a shot. It's a big sucker, and I'll show you in a clip coming up just how big it is. It's a shoulder cam, and it is imposing.
6 hours later.
I don't get a new kit. I'm building myself a DeBoer's big kit, almost, what is it, 4 feet long. Created over at DeBoer Halls. My friend Dennis is doing it for me, but he can't get it to me till March. Well, that means we've got January, February, and then March. So I have 8-9 weeks to kill. I was either going to spend it on that, and if I have any time left over, I might build myself Halcyon Nostromo kit that I've had for 15 years, or a Hanibu from Squadron, something along that lines, because I just can't sit here and go, gosh, what's on TV today? That's not my style. I got to do something. I mean, there's plenty of housework and all that, but once I get done with that, you know, mowing the lawn or whatever, I gotta do something. Yeah, that's just the way it is. So, I know, I'm freaking nuts. So, not gonna be the longest video, as usual, but we will give you a good look at the Sulaco, which came out really, really nice. Doug, the bass guy across the street, my buddy, excellent carpenter, did a really nice flat sheet of oak cut and beautifully sanded, in which I stained stainless steel poles with 3D printed rod inserts. Very nice, very nice. Came out real well. And then the 3D printed plaque, dedication plaque, which is a big thing with all kinds of info on it, that Robert James, who's the guy who designed the kit, also sent me a file for. And I just did the other night, I finished up painting the a designation, the Sulaco, on the side of, on each side, left and right, starboard and port, of the, you know, that Sulaco M on USS Sulaco. And, it, you know, I like decals for facility, but I'm still waiting on some decals from a buddy, J-Bot, Jim Botitis. They didn't come in, and I wanted to wrap it up. So I'll definitely use them if I build it again. And I'm sorry, Jim, it's been like a couple weeks now, and I'm still waiting, and I wanted to finish it up. So, I guess that's it. So I guess we shall move on, and I hope this clip came out, because this big beast is staring at me, and it's going, you better use me. So here it is. This is the Sulaco. Like I said, almost 3 feet long. Really nice size. Got this lovely oak plaque done with there's a designation plaque. Everything is 3D printed except for the stainless and the wood. Beautifully done. Thank you, Robert James, for sending it to me all the way from Australia. Lovely. Of course, now I'm getting better on the 3D printer. I'll be able to print them up by myself. I'm not sure the Dremel can handle something like this. But, well, I may look into buying a different one that does different things. But the Dremel's been wonderful to learn on, I must say. So we'll take a closer look at this, and I'll turn off the lights so we can check out this new camera's capability on low light filming. Because that's really the main issue I bought, other than it's very impressive and you can whack King Kong out with it, which is a big plus. Let's move on. So here she is. Let me see here. So many buttons on this thing. It's frightening. It really is. So you can get a look here. It's got pretty decent magnification. Let me straighten her up. God, it's so heavy. This is going to be a joy for Steve, the cameraman, to haul around. Not me, man. Oh, ooh, not bad. A lot of plate detailing. Lots of effects. The barrels are slightly metallized. That was, geez, this thing's a beast. Wow, look at the mag on this thing. That's excellent. I strictly use paste and everything to keep it subtle because the color overall was very, very uniform, monochrome. You can see the one lighted port I did. That's some cannons right there. I do believe the great big side projections are rail guns. I see no other purpose for them. There's your bottom gun. Wow, I cannot believe the magnification on this thing. That is superior. That's just amazing. Wow, that's something else. And then back here, again, a lot of plating. You're seeing mostly the dark ones. There's also light ones that aren't coming out as well, but you can kind of make them out here. There you go. Holy Toledo, this thing's a magnifier. Wow. Very impressive. There's a lot of detail everywhere. When I was taking off all the decals and the masks I put on there, my God, there was hundreds of them. You're just making out some of them. In person, it's far more impressive, but you get the concept. There you have from this side. That's not doing too bad. There's the blinky winky, also known as the nav light. There's not a lot of lighting in here. And there's your two forward antenna lightings. Let me spin it around to the back. There's your blue beacon. Yeah, here's that pulsing engine lighting. Boy, that is almost cinematic. Whoa. That'll work, huh? Not bad. Love that Corona. Boy, when it does that, it's so cool. It's hypnotic. Take it away. And down this side. I cannot believe the magnification on this guy. That is amazing. Alright, let's take a look from the front. Again, not a lot of lighting details on this guy. It's just not part of the... And from the front, very cool. And I love it. And you can see my shadow there. Yes, it's a giant space monster. And again, the mag on this is incredible. And there's your nav lighting and all that stuff. So let's take a close look at it now. Like I said, lighting wise, it is not the most interesting thing, but I wanted to add a little bit. All right, one last look before it goes on my shelf, not in a box, which is damn nice. For a change, I get to keep one. And we're gonna go down a little bit here and take a look at the plaque. The plaque is pretty cool. Let's see. Oh, this thing's heavy, 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 heavy hitter. And as you can see, there's denotations on the weight. For instance, propulsion unit, auxiliary craft, which it denotes four drop ships, Wayland, building better worlds, length 1,280 feet, mass 70,000 metric tons, height 280 feet, width, 1,242 feet, big sucker, Sulaco, what was it? It's a light assault carrier. So I did a silver, bronze sort of highlighting with a antique gold base. Looks good. Beautiful oak base. So that was just a nice little touch. And, oh, didn't have that centered. Oh, well, forgive. So for now, Papa Smurf, the Sulaco. See ya!
Well, this is Jerry Jasmine filling in for Walter Cronkite. What? He's dead. So, here in La, which is like Tinseltown, well, we've caught wind of a story happening somewhere in Florida, some little town, I don't know. And apparently Bobo, some of you know, is the world's most famous closet monster. I guess he never came out. Hey, come on, Bobo. It's 2018, you know? Anyways, he's a closet monster, you know. Oh, think about the parameters. Anyway, so apparently there's a whole big news crew out there. A whole lot of paparazzi. And they're out there waiting for him to emerge for the first time in 100 years out of this guy's closet. Yeah. I know. The jokes are endless. Tell me about it. I'm getting thirsty here. Oh, man, that's good. Oh. Good bubbly. Anyways, so we're waiting for him to emerge. Apparently, it's a once-in-a-century thing. And we just caught on to some rotors or rooters or, you know, whatever, a news service. Jesus. And we're waiting. Okay, the live feed is picking up now. Apparently, the door has opened. The door has opened. Oh, my. Now, apparently, this thing, like, isn't interdimensional, or I don't know what. And he lives in there, and the guy that lives there, I don't know what he does. He gives him candy, and he's been around since the boy was young. Again, you know, man, the jokes just abound. You could go nuts. We'll see what happens. I believe there's a foot emerging. Some Shondo or something. Oh, back on camera. Oh, so, yes, they're waiting. What does that say? Maybe next time. Oh, come on, Jesus. So now we gotta wait another 100 years. Oh, come on. Oh, this is just not right.
¶¶